So speaking of which, you had a pretty contentious. So you ran against Justin Barry, who is right now the GOP nominee, and things got a little contentious while you were contesting. And I want you to describe your race, what your platform was, and what you feel like, how you feel you've been treated by the Board of Elections with the outcome and whatnot.
Okay, so the primary was in March. There were five of us that ran, and I led the primary by 10 points. And second and third place was separated by one vote. So Justin Barry and Don Zimmerman were, Justin Barry beat Don Zimmerman by one vote.
Yeah.
So then the runoff should have been in May, but it got delayed until July because of COVID.
Mm-hmm.
And so we campaigned-ish. I mean, you know, in COVID there was, I did some door knocking, but there was a lot of things that we weren't able to do because of COVID. We couldn't have the big gatherings or the big meetings where we could get ourselves more known, whatever. So, but I still did a lot of door knocking. So we went into the runoff. I expected to win, to be honest. I expected to win by a lot. I think I was predicted to be the winner by most people. And in the runoff, Justin won. So the results came in on election night at 8:30. The early vote came in. He was ahead 55-45.
Mm.
And then at about 9:30, half the precincts came in and he was ahead 55-45. Like the percentage didn't change at all. And then at 1:30 in the morning, the remaining precincts came in and he was ahead 55-45. No change. So for me, I have a degree in accounting and I'm a lawyer, but for me, that was statistically improbable that the percentages would not change. So I reached out to some people who happened to have gotten possession of the audit logs for Travis County, the Travis County election. And what the audit logs produced was that our ballots were entered illegally. They were deleted at 11 p.m. at night on election night. All of our ballots were deleted. Some ballots were recreated, and then they were re-entered, which is why we didn't get the final results until 1:30 in the morning. So I'm not saying that I should have won. I guess I did say already that I should have won.
Yeah, you already let that out, Jen.
But the audit log shows that there was so much illegal activity that the outcome is not knowable. And so I did file an election contest, which I'm not pursuing anymore, because there's no way for me to have resolved that prior to the November election. So right now I spend most of my time, my free time, trying to bring awareness that we don't have legal elections in Travis County, and that the Travis County clerk, Dana Debevoise, is an operative. She's a criminal. Criminal charges were referred against her to the AG, and
right, but
they're
he's in a little hot
there.
Water. He's in right. a little bit of hot right. water right now, right. too. So
right. So our AG Paxton has a lot of his own problems right now. Plus, there's a lot of voter fraud happening in Harris County, which is the biggest county in Texas, and so we're just not getting the attention that it deserves in Travis County. But the voters need to know that they need to keep an eye on her, and we may not get a legal election.